Retro editing is everywhere right now, but slapping on some grain or a VHS overlay just doesn't cut it anymore. And as an editor, you need to understand the intentionality behind the effects that you're applying. In this video, we'll be walking through three retro aesthetics and how you can create them the right way. Let's go ahead and jump into Premiere. So here I have a short sequence made up that showcases some retro content, which is the first key of implementing these retro aesthetics and effects correctly. So to get started, let's go ahead and duplicate our footage layer that we want to be affecting. And it's a good idea to go ahead and extend this a little bit further. And then we'll right click and select Replace with After Effects Composition. This is going to port over the clip into After Effects, as you can see here. Now, I already had After Effects open. If not, you'll be prompted to choose the save location for your project. So we have our composition in After Effects. The first thing that we want to tackle is changing the aspect ratio to this classic 4:3. So in order to do that, you can come up to Composition, Composition Settings, and for a 4:3 aspect ratio, you'll want to change these numbers to 1280 by 960. With the correct aspect ratio, now just scale your footage to fit. So you can select the footage layer you want to affect and click S on the keyboard. Now you can hold Command if you'd like to make smaller movements and just scale your footage to fit within this layer. So the first step is going to be adding a little bit of warmth to this layer. So what we can do is duplicate our footage and with the top layer selected, change the blend mode to luminosity. So now with our footage set up correctly, we can add a handful of effects to the bottom layer of footage. So we'll come over to the effects and presets window and search for brightness and contrast. Go ahead and add that on the bottom layer. Then noise, just this standard noise effect. And finally, directional blur. So we can bring the blur effect over. Now there's a couple settings we'll want to tweak in each of these parameters. So for brightness and contrast, raise the brightness up to somewhere between 30 and 40%. Same thing with the noise here as well. We'll go ahead and raise that to 40 and make sure that this use color noise is applied. And for the blur direction, go ahead and change that to 90 degrees and the length to about 9 looks good for this. So now we can toggle these effects off and on and see that we have a little bit of noise in this image overall. I do want to note that VHS tapes aren't inherently glitchy. This really is only caused by a faulty player or dirty or damaged tape in some way. There's a really fantastic exploration of this idea by the 8-bit guy, which I've linked in the description down below if you're interested in learning more. The next step is to add a few effects to the top layer. Those effects are noise, so we can grab that, drag it onto the top, and Gaussian blur. For the noise, you'll want to set this between 5 and 8% on the top layer. So we'll go ahead and go with 8 just to make it nice and blurry. And then for the blurriness, you can set that between 3 and 5. All right, so the footage is starting to look really organic. The next step is to add an interlacing effect. To create this interlacing effect, what we can do is select both of our footage layers and then pre-compose. Now duplicate this layer and rename it to interlacing and then just nudge it back one single frame. With that completed, go ahead and select the Venetian blinds effect and apply it to this top layer. Once you're in the effect parameters, grab this transition completion and change that to 50% with the blur direction or the direction to negative 90 or 90, doesn't matter, and the width to 4 or 5. I think 5 looks good for this footage. And with that done, you can see that we have this really cool interlacing effect that takes place anywhere where there's quick pans or really movement in the frame. This effect is looking really good, but there's one more thing to apply, and that's color bleeding. So in order to do that, go ahead and duplicate the bottom layer. Then you can rename this to color bleeding. And the effect we'll want to put on here is chromatic aberrations. So you can go ahead and apply that to your middle layer. And then you can just press T to pull up the opacity and reduce this to between 15 and 20%. So now it's a lot more subtle of an effect than being really jarring. Now, of course, you can always tweak this to however you would like, but I find that 15 to 20% is a really nice range. So now you have a clean VHS aesthetic for your video, but if you want things to be a bit more stylistic or grungy, then stick around for part two of this video where we'll be adding a few overlays. A common mistake with overlays is that people will add them in, change the blend mode, and then call it a day. But there's no interaction with the footage, so it can often feel a bit foreign when added in. So let's show you how to fix that. So the first step when working with overlays is going to be adding an overlay to your project. So I'm going to use the Storyblocks plugin. And in here, the first thing I like to do is always make sure that my download settings are correct. So we can confirm we're downloading to our project files, and then just click confirm. And there's a couple different ways that you can work with assets that you'd already found with Storyblocks. So the easiest way to do that is by using this My Folders, and then I'd already saved two of these assets that I think will work really well for this clip. The other way though is that every asset has a unique asset ID. So if you copy this asset ID and then paste it anywhere within the plugin, within the search bar here, it'll pull up that exact asset. So since I did that already, we'll go ahead and download. And I like to download the highest quality possible for overlays so that After Effects has the most information available. And then just to showcase how it works when downloading from a folder, we can go into our Retro Isn't Dead project and download the highest quality version of this other overlay here. With that done, you can go ahead, close the Storyblocks plugin, and now you can go ahead and add your overlay into the project. Just drag it on top and change the blend mode to add. I know that add works well for this one. It might be screen or add depending on the asset. Now, this is where a lot of people will stop, but you can take it to the next level by going up to displacement map and then dragging that effect onto the bottom layer. And now, under the displacement map layer, you can select this top distortion preset. And for horizontal, use luminance, and for vertical, use luminance as well. Once that's complete, you can change the max horizontal to 25, and same thing for vertical. Now, on this example, you can see there's some black bars that have appeared. So in order to fix that, you'll just want to scale up your footage slightly to get rid of these black bars. And now your displacement is going to perfectly match the footage that's on top. Now this distortion is looking really good, but there's one more effect I want to add, which is adding this heads up display. So go ahead and drag that on top and then press S to go ahead and scale and fit this appropriately to our composition here. And you can change the blend mode to add or screen. I think for this particular one, screen looks really good. And if we play this back, you can see it looks pretty good, but because we have so much distortion being applied to the footage, the heads up display, again, it looks out of place. So the last thing to really cement and bring all of this together, select your clean VHS layer and the displacement map, and then go ahead and paste that same effect onto your heads up display. And now with the effect applied, just go ahead and adjust your position slightly since it got shifted around a little bit with that past effect. And now the displacement map affects the heads up display, it affects the footage overall, and I'm really happy with this final result. So this is your final boss VHS aesthetic. But if you were looking for a more filmic or organic feel, then stick around for part three of this video as I jump into DaVinci Resolve. For this last effect, we'll be taking a look at adding film damage and light leaks. Light leaks were really popularized in the DSLR era, which doesn't make a ton of sense to me since they're really from light leaking into a frame, probably because there are some bad seals or the film's being mishandled. And again, these are flaws. So really it comes down to the intentionality of using them maybe as a C camera, but there needs to be intention behind the shot. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump into DaVinci Resolve. And we can get started on the color page. So with our clip selected, the first thing I'm going to do is actually add a little bit of blur just to reduce a little bit of the sharpness that comes in. Then create a new node, go up to effects and add camera shake. And drag that onto the node. Now there's a lot of parameters within this effect, but what we're trying to do is emulate gate weave. So that looks like small jitter, not chaotic handheld movement. This motion is looking really good to me though. So the next step is going to be to add a little bit of film grain. So you can just search for the film grain effect and slap that onto a new node. And we can keep the preset as 16mm. The opacity you can change to 0.75. This way it's not too on the nose, but does just add a little bit more grit to the footage. And now we have the grain added as well as this gate weave effect. So now jumping back into the edit page, go ahead and add your overlay onto video track 3. And you can trim this to fit your footage as well. And then come up to the inspector and resize to fit the composition that you're working with. My particular composition is sized as 4x3 to fit that classic kind of retro aesthetic. And then under composite mode, come down to darken, or you might need to experiment a little bit depending on your overlay. Some work better than others. The goal is obviously to get your footage being seen behind a transparent layer as the frame is a black background. So darken works really well for my particular footage. The overlay is now looking really good. The final step is going to be to add a light leak. And when I'm adding a light leak, I like to look for a section that has a lot of variance, a lot going on. Again, light leaks are best used when they're transitional elements. So just a lot of flashing towards the end for just a few frames is really what I'm looking for when applying light leaks. So I found that section here. You can go ahead and drag it into your timeline. And then you'll want to just zoom it to fit your entire composition and change the composite mode. For this particular one, I found that soft light works really well. So we'll go ahead and change the composite mode to soft light. And there you go. You have a few frames at the very end that serve as a little bit of a transition into the next clip. If you have any questions as you're experimenting with these effects in your videos, just leave them in the comments down below and I'll do my best to get to every single one. And if you're interested in downloading any of the overlays, like the examples that I used in this video, then head over to storyblocks.com where you can get unlimited stock media downloads for one set price.